We're here to talk about Bobby Dylan, and thanks to the organisers for, I suppose, acknowledging Dylan at 70. He's just one of those people, you know. He's one of those guys. Born May 24th, 1941, in southern Duluth, Minnesota. Lived there for a while until he was 6 years of age. Moved up then to Hibbing with the family. Had brothers and sisters. His real name was Robert Allen Zimmerman. And then, if I can get this right, if I could find it, if I can find it, his name in Hebrew is Shabtai Zizel Ben Avraham. Because he's Jewish. His father was Jewish, mother Jewish. She's Beatrice Stone. 1955 to 59, went off to University of Minnesota in Minneapolis. Didn't stay too long. Didn't like it that much. So headed off to a place called New York. Main Street New York, as we'd say, in 1961. Played coffee houses, met his hero, Woody Guthrie. Got signed to CBS under John Hammond. And cut his first album, Bob Dylan, in 1962. Had just two of his own songs on that album. The rest were covers. And now if you go onto the CBS or onto the Dylan website, you'll find 56 albums on bobdylan.com. But there are a load more. For those of us who collect Dylan albums, there are some great albums that don't have the CBS stamp on them or the Sony stamp on them. But anyway, we'll say nothing about that yet. Dylan did all the usual stuff in the 60s. We all know about Dylan. We think about him as kind of, you know, the man who kind of introduced psychedelic, whatever it was, to rock music. But he was into all that kind of stuff that nobody's into now. And burnt out in the mid-60s, went touring all over the shop. Reported to have a motorcycle accident in 67, was laid low, went up to Woodstock in upstate New York, and came back then in 1967 with an album with just himself and the guitar, just an acoustic album. We call it the Bible album, John Wesley Harding album. And doodled about, as we say, in the 70s, his marriage was falling apart, got divorced, but then he came back and did a beautiful album in 75, Blood on the Track. We'll come through all this in a minute. Went back on the road with a group called The Band. The great title, Bob Dylan and The Band. You know, The Band, Ronnie Roberts, all those guys, you know them from the Hawks. Canadian, mostly Canadian. Dylan is into art, reading, history, especially the American Civil War. Beautiful song, if you're into the American Civil War. It's from a series on TV in America called Gods and Generals. And Dylan did a song on it called Cross the Green Mountain. Now on the TV you get the 3-minute version, but there is an 8-minute version available. And I would highly, highly recommend it. It's an absolutely superb piece of writing and superb music. The only Dylan album song to me is it's called Telltale Signs. It was released there a couple of years ago. And it's kind of a compilation stuff in the bootleg series, which we talk about. And then, as I say, 80s and 90s, Dylan was kind of, you know, there were a few little gems, all right, but it was mainly trouble, as I said, just lying low and doing a bit of touring, and people turned their backs on him, and I suppose in a sense, him turning his back on people as well. Tours, believe it or not, at age 70, does 100 gigs minimum a year, and has done that since 1988. And as we speak, it's now 9 o'clock, 9:15, whatever time it is in Italy, he's in Florence on stage. That's where he is. He's in the middle of a tour. It started in Dublin on October 6th this year. And Mark Knopfler does openers. And Knopfler comes on and does 4 or 5 songs with Dylan. And then Dylan takes the rest. But he didn't do it in Dublin, of course. Knopfler didn't come on until about the 5th gig or something like that, you know. But he's touring and will be in London again if anyone wants to walk to London. He's finishing up with 3 dates in London at the end of this month. 19th, 20th or 21st or something like that. Some people call it the never-ending tour. I don't know about the title. But let's go back a bit. 63. He released Free Willy. This was his first album, his first, you know, writing his own songs. And here is a guy, he's 21 years of age. And if I say, on that album you had Blowing in the Wind, Girl from the North Country, Masters of War, A Hard Rain's a Gonna Fall, and Don't Think Twice, It's All Right. All those from the one album. There were other songs on it, but most people who listen to anybody Dylan would recognise those songs straight away. And this kid was only 21 years of age. And let me just do one verse. When I say do, I mean read. I won't frighten you. I won't be sticking knives in you, like that fella. Here's from Masters of War. You fasten the triggers for the others to fire. Then you sit back and watch when the death count gets higher. You hide in your mansion as young people's blood flows out of their bodies and is buried in the mud. This was followed then with the album Times They Are A Changing. You know the shot there, bottom left shot on that big poster. It's a bit like that, the Times They Are A Changing shot. Dylan singing this tidy song in an open G sound, which I always open G or open D, whatever it is, an open an open corridor, and it's a twangy sound that I have to say myself, I detest above every other evil. I think it's a ghastly sound. But that's beside the point. But it's a great sound. It's a brilliant, brilliant sound. Times the air are changing. Let's do a small bit of it. Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, don't criticize what you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. Your old road is rapidly aging. Please get out of the new one if you can't lend a hand, for the times, they are a-changing. The line it has drawn, the curse it has cast, the slow one now will later be fast, as the present now will later be past. The order is rapidly fading, and the first one now will later be last, for the times, they are a-changing. Now, that was followed by another side of Bob Dylan, but songs that some people might remember, Ballad of Hollis Brown. Lovely story about a man who ended up killing himself and his wife and the family, in American Dust Bowl time. That was one of the songs he sang on that debacle when he appeared on Live Aid in 1985, if you remember, with Ron Wood and Keith Richard. And one was, as I say, more pissed than the other. But anyway, that was one of the songs he sang that day. On that album as well, you have this lovely song, With God on Our Side. I'm sure most people here would know the song, The Patriot Game, written by Behan. Well, Dylan, of course, as Mankan said earlier on, when he got to New York, he was like a sponge. He just soaked up every form of music. And of course, folk music at the time was that you just soaked up all the other music around you, and he made it his own. So he borrowed the melody, and he wrote his own song, With God on Our Side. He's done that consistently, and still does it, even on the last album. Still does it. At 70 years of age, he's still at it. Another few lovely songs from that album, One Too Many Mornings, Only a Pawn in Their Game, Boots of Spanish Leather. Beautiful, beautiful love song. Absolutely beautiful. And to hear, I heard one of the most beautiful versions I've heard of it was Dylan in Dublin in 2005. Here he was, what's that, many years ago, 6 years ago. So he was 64 or whatever it was. And to sing that song and to kind of get the both sides, it's two people talking, the boy and the girl talking. It's absolutely beautiful. Another song, When the Ship Comes In, The Lonesome Death of Hattie Carroll. True story. William Zanzinger killed poor Hattie Carroll with a cane that he twirled around his diamond ring finger. A rich man killing the black servant. That's basically what it was. And he got 6 months for the trouble, basically. And then the other song on that is Restless Farewell, which again is a borrowing or a rip-off of Parting Glass. Isn't that it, Tony? The Parting Glass, yeah. So, he then got this name as the protest singer. A lot of people say Dylan is a protest singer, but Dylan himself would always say, I'm not a protest singer. And of course, in the 80s then and 90s, when he tours, if he does speak, he doesn't normally speak at concerts, sometimes when he introduces one of the Christian songs, I remember one time at a concert, him singing In the Garden. You know, when they came for him in the garden, did they know he was the Son of God? Did they know that he was Lord? And he introduced them and said, oh, this is a protest sound. It's typical Dylan. So that's... on the another side of Bob Dylan, the ones that people might know is All I Really Want to Do, Chimes of Freedom, To Ramona, most beautiful song. My Back Pages, the refrain from that. I was so much older then, I'm younger than that now. Jerry Boyd knows that song, she loves that song. And then, of course, the final song on it was a song called It Ain't Me, Babe. Go away from my window, leave at your own chosen speed. I'm not the one you want, babe, I'm not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone, never weak, but always strong, to protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door, but it ain't me, babe. No, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. Lovely love song, lovely goodbye love song. But really what he's saying he's not a protest singer, he's not a leader, he's going to do his one thing. So he was saying goodbye to all the nonsense that accrued, because people love to have people they look up to, and leaders, and people to think for them and all that. So he was having none of that. I mentioned a lovely song, To Ramona. To Ramona.
Your sadness will pass as your senses will rise. The flowers of the city don't breath like, get dead like sometimes. And no use in trying to deal with the dying, so I cannot explain that in life. Your cracked country lips I still wish to kiss, as to be by the strength of your skin. Your magnetic movements still capture the minutes I'm in. To grieve my heart, love, Cause he tried to be a part of a world that just don't exist. It's all just a dream, babe, a vacuum, a scheme, babe, that sucks you into feeling like this. I see that your head has been twisted and fed with worthless foam from the mud. I see you are torn between sin and returning back to the saddle. You've been fooled into thinking that the finishing end is at hand. There's no one to beat you, no one to defeat you, except the thoughts of yourself feeling bad. Heard you say many times that you're better than no one, and no one is better than you. If you really believe that, then you know you got nothing to win and nothing to lose. From fixtures and forces and friends, your sorrows don't stand. We'll hype you and type you and forever talk to you and make you want to feel just like them. I forever talk to you, but I know that my world would turn into a meaningless rain. For deep in my heart, I know there's no help I can bring. Everything passes, everything changes. Do what you think you should do. Who knows, maybe someday, baby, I'll come and